Hey folks, welcome to my second YouTube gaming video. I received some nice comments about the first one, so I thought about making a second one, and this is it. Again with a rather unusual and rare tank. This is the M4A2E4 Sherman. It is the beta gift tank. What does that mean? The tank was given to anyone at the end of the beta, when the game officially went live, who had 1,000 matches under their belt. Or at least that's what it is on the North America and European server. The tank isn't available anymore on those two servers, but you can still get it on the Russian server as a standard premium. I believe it's 1500 gold, if it's still available. And it's apparently available on the Southeast Asian server as a special reward for a mission. Historically, only two prototypes were ever produced, with the intention to see if they could improve the armor protection. As such, the frontal armor is slowed back more than the standard Sherman. The other thing they did was replace the standard bogey suspension that you see on most Shermans with a torsion bar suspension. It has become one of the rarest tanks to be seen in World of Tanks. While it was incredibly common and you could have games entirely made up of nothing but these Shermans immediately after the launch, I haven't actually seen one in at least a year and a half. So what do you need to know if you actually run into one of these tanks during a game? Well, it's basically what Wargaming wants every premium to be. It's better than a stock tier 5 Sherman. It isn't quite as good as a fully upgraded tier 5 Sherman. The tank is stuck with the 75mm short barrel that you start off with on the standard Sherman. It's an acceptable weapon for tier 4 and 5, but you are going to struggle against tier 6 tanks, and even at tier 5 against heavies you have got to be careful and make your shots count, because penetration on this gun is not very good. Anything with a slope or just good armor and you won't get through it. You'll have to get in the sides or the rear to penetrate. Don't bother with the premium ammunition. The premium ammunition has the same penetration and damage values as the 76mm gun on the normal Sherman or even the tier 6 Shermans, and it's simply not worth it. To get the maximum out of this gun, you have to get in close, where you can have the rapid rate of fire make up for the other shortcomings like penetration, damage, and yeah, quite frankly, poor accuracy. The maneuverability of the tank is quite decent. It is perfectly capable of dogfighting with tier 4 and tier 5 mediums, and it can outturn things like the KV-1, so you won't struggle with that. Although it isn't quite as fast and isn't quite as good at acceleration as the normal Sherman is. It doesn't quite have the engine power. You're basically stuck with what on the standard Sherman would be the second engine, so it suffers at that point. The best feature compared to the normal Sherman is the frontal armor. While it isn't actually thicker, it's sloped back further, so the actual armor value is higher, and at tier 4 and 5 you can easily bounce a lot of shots. Just don't expect it to work against tank destroyers, some heavy tanks or other tanks that are noted to have high penetration guns. A Matilda will get through, but other tanks that have a similar penetration as this specific Sherman has, so which is 95mm I believe, it's quite easy to bounce, especially if you get the chance to angle. Just keep in mind it has the same side armor as a standard Sherman, so basically paper thin. Don't angle too much or make sure your flank is covered. If you get the chance to get your hands on one of these tanks, I suggest you take it. It's a tier 5 Sherman, sure, But it has premium matchmaking. It won't ever see tier 7s. At least I haven't seen any in the games I've played in a long while. It's a premium as set, and it counts as a premium. It doesn't count as a gift tank. So it has all the benefits. Cheaper to repair, cheaper to run. The ammunition is dirt cheap, and you get the extra income. So it's a good tier 5 moneymaker. On the Russian server, spend the gold, get it if it's still available. On the Southeast Asian server, do the missions, it's worth it. The North American and European servers, sorry guys, but as far as I know, this will never come up for sale ever again, so you're out of luck. Here you can actually see some of the gun performance of the 75mm. If you've been watching, as long as the Panzer IV kept pointing his hull at me, I could get through quite easily. The moment he turned and angled the hull while pulling back, the shot bounced. The 76mm on the fully upgraded normal Sherman would have gotten through. He's pulling back. The rest of the enemy team is pulling back and the others are advancing, so let's go after them. At this point you'll be able to see the higher top speed of the M4 A2 E4. Although you'll never see that top speed on a flat section of map. It simply doesn't have the engine power to get up to speed, and you'll only see it downhill. The warning is for a tank destroyer that is hiding in the starting area of the opposing team. I actually don't see any shots coming out of from that area, so I decide to go on up ahead. But he is there since my ally just blew up. Climbing is a bit slower, lack of engine power. And there comes a Crusader. Paper for armor, so no problem putting a shot into him before he gets killed by the guys on the hill. Shot bounced off of a burnt out wreck, and there's the T-67 tank destroyer hiding in the bushes. That was one hit. And here pretty much the game is over at this point, and just get two more shots into him. He kills me, the others kill them. Game essentially over. Which is one of the things you have to watch. The frontal armor is better than the standard Sherman, but most tank destroyers will simply go through anyway. Same with things like with gun like a Matilda, which has a high penetration value. It will just go through. Lower penetration values, 6-pounder guns, other guns with similar performance to the 75, angle the tank, and there's a good chance that it will bounce. Last game. Heading off to the traditional medium tank area. We're going to go up to the ridge on the western side of the map, which is normally the one of the two choke points on the map, the other being the section on the peninsula. French Heavy with us, a couple of other mediums including a jumbo, and we'll see what we can see as we come up to the ridge. Gun depression on the tank is actually pretty good, so you can work ridge lines, although it doesn't have a particularly strong mantle, so or turret armor for that matter in general. And here comes a T1 if I'm not mistaken, and I do not want to engage this guy. He has the better gun, battle frontal armor, and I simply wouldn't be able to get close and around him in time, and have enough time to take him out before he takes me out. So I'm actually waiting for one of the others to go first. And there they go, so I can join them. Although I did wait too long, and now I really don't get a chance to do any damage to him. Artillery shot almost blew off our friend over there. Actually, if the driver dies on this tank, you should heal him almost immediately. I actually don't do it for quite a while, and it costs me time and a couple of opportunities to get in and around the opponents and do damage. And a kill. And a critical. As you can see, like I said, gun depression is decent, and I'm about to head up to support our teammate in front of us. I'm actually going to go up and through and over in a second to get around the side and do damage to whatever is hiding behind the cliff. Artillery takes another shot, not aimed at me, but at the French heavy. And now that we've got back up, up and over, go get him. I finally noticed the driver. Team is doing well, only four enemy tanks left and it's basically mopping up. So we're going ahead, we're going to head around the side and try and get some damage done. Probably won't work. Inaccuracy of the gun on the move. Get another kill. And that was friendly fire. Thanks, buddy. Not the best ending to the game. Results. Middle of the field. Top 5 or top 6. Decent results, nothing special. And thanks for watching this video on a very rare Sherman.